guys.
Happy Easter.
This may be the only car in the show. I have no idea.
First on the lot.
It's going to be good.
Inside you.
Gorgeous.
Thank you.
Yeah,
those new shoes are, you know, fancy, and they will not last for being white for much longer.
No. What does Easter mean to you, Wes? Other than free coffee at a car show.
Well, I go back to when I was a kid and doing Easter egg hunts with the family and stuff.
We got some of those.
I know. Well, it's the same plastic eggs. That's what my grandfather used to do. Money. It was never candy. It was always money.
Right.
Yeah. So.
Okay. Well, I don't know how much money's in them, but good luck.
Yeah.
What do you got in your hands?
So, I have some chocolate. Little Easter. Trying to theme it. I'm liking that we have the white cars going on.
We have the white car section.
I love that.
What does Easter mean to you? Besides chocolate and bunny ears.
Cars.
Right here. Well, I guess the party can start now. Randy,
I could use a big, deep dish of coffee.
Good morning, brother.
Good morning.
This is Bill. Met this young man at Donut Derelicts.
And
you were driving a Lincoln.
Right.
And you're now driving a
68 Buick Riviera.
It's gorgeous.
Oh, thank you.
Why this car? How long have you had this?
I've had it for about 15 years.
Okay.
I bought it on my, on my way to fly back to Florida, back home, and I saw it sitting somewhere, and I canceled my flight. When I saw the car, I said, oh boy, this thing's calling my name. So
this was Frank Sinatra's favorite car.
Was it really?
Yeah, and I also like the coat. People are just coming over and hugging him just because it's so soft. Here, this young man. What's up, Rodney?
How you doing there, Fireball?
Thanks for joining us today. We got a lot of great cars.
But, yes, indeed.
So far, Ken's doing his job up here. What's your favorite so far?
Wow. You know what? My dad had a Corvair. I love the 57.
That's no normal Corvair.
Yeah. Sure.
That's a scary one.
Yeah, I heard that coming in. I was like, that does not sound like a Corvair.
That's awesome.
57. This beautiful 67 Mustang. Actually, I had a 68 that was white with burgundy interior, just like that was my second car. Man, it's just cool.
It's hard to choose. If I had a chance every weekend, I'd just grab one and just go for a spin.
That's the ideal life.
Yeah.
That's the ideal life.
All right. Well, I appreciate you coming.
Man, I'm Fireball Tim, baddest man in town.
Thanks for coming.
Talking cars. And by the way, we're also looking at window stickers.
Oh, yes.
Easily peel offable and available for free.
Right here, right now.
Right here, right now. So get over here right now.
Greg Gill from the Automobile Driving Museum and the Greg Gill Company. What did you bring in this Bonneville?
What did I bring in? It's a 1960 Bonneville convertible. 383 cubic inches. This car we use a lot for parades. It's been retrofitted with parade fans.
Yeah.
And it's a driver. We drive it. We send it out all the time.
Well then, since I know that.
Well, now, knowledge is power.
Brent, and there are a lot of very large cars in this show.
Yes, sir.
But not yours.
No.
Yours is kind of like a half car.
Yeah. It's a smaller wheelbase than a Volkswagen Beetle.
What year is this?
1958 Nash Metropolitan.
Why black and white?
You know what? When I got it, it was some black and white primer, so I figured I'd just sand on it a little bit more.
What is it about these cars? They're just the coolest little things. They're easy to work on.
Super easy to work on. Lots of parts availability.
Yeah.
Great club support. And there's super fun little cars to drive.
What's your business?
No, I'm a set dresser by Yahtzee, Local 44.
All right, awesome. Thanks for coming, man.
Thank you, sir.
All right. Appreciate it.
Rodney's doing Facebook Live.
There we go. We're Facebook Live here, Fireball.
We're shooting you right now.
This is Scotty Martin, world's most incredible car photographer. I can say that. You go to so many shows, it's quite extraordinary. And last year you did six shows in one day.
Well, it was a record for me.
Yes.
Could be a record.
And now you're going to attempt something new.
This year the moons and stars do not align to get to seven shows in 2017 in one day.
You need a Scotty Martin Xerox machine.
I need to be split in three.
Right, so you're gonna do how many shows in 2 days?
I'm doing it over 2 days, and I'm trying for 12 shows in 2 days.
Epic.
And Saturday is going to be the Orange County run, and then Sunday is going to be Malibu into Supercar Sunday,
all right,
and culminating in the Greystone Mansion in the concourse.
I think you should add one more stop, and that should be the hospital after the end of the second day.
I'll be ready for it.
The man right here.
Thanks, guys.
Thanks for coming, man.
Great time at the show. Really incredible people. But it actually got me thinking about something, and it's been percolating in my mind a bit. Each individual person that brings a car to this show, they look at life a particular way. They design life based on how they think and the direction, the flow of their thoughts. And that got me thinking is that how do people really manifest things in their lives? And the answer is very easy, but it requires a visual. I got an idea. As I see it, your life consists of two colors. The first one is red. And the second one is green. Now the red one consists of all the negative thoughts you think and all the negative situations that you manifest in your life. The green is all the positive thoughts you think and all the positive situations that you manifest in your life. Now, red ones maybe like a certain amount of money, relationships, your health. And then the same thing goes for the green side, the positive side. It's whatever you think of. Now, what we don't realize is that these thoughts about all these things is what moves forward. The more that we concentrate on these aspects of our lives, the more we manifest aspects of those components. So the more you concentrate on work and the negative side of work, like people that you're working with that you don't want to work with, or you're not doing what you love, or people that are kind of pains that you kind of have to deal with, or you don't have enough money, or maybe your health is not where it needs to be. The more you concentrate on the negative side of all this, the more that moves forward. All of that moves forward in your life. And that whole thing becomes your world. Now you can do the same thing on the positive side. You can have a work that you love, it's really cool. You can have people in your life that you love and that love you. You can have plenty of money and enough money to do all the things that you want. And you can have really good health and feel good all the time. And that, when you think about those things in that capacity, that moves forward. And that becomes your experience. Now, most people don't have this or this. They have a combination of the two. They have, well, let's use a different color. They may have work over here that's negative, but they have good relationships with people. Or they may have really good work, but they have bad health. Or they may have really bad people in their life, but they got plenty of money. Most people have a combination of this. So these things end up doing this. And that's what someone's life ends up looking like. And all of this moves forward. Now, what I want you to get, people, what I want you to understand is that your life may be a combination of these things, but if you live your life unconsciously, meaning if you think that all of these things are out of your control and you're reacting to your work or your people or your money or the bad things in your life and you're just reacting and you're not being proactive, you're not taking control, then your life progresses forward like a casino game. It's a crapshoot. You don't really know what you're going to get. You're hoping for the best. You're thinking, you know, the best that you can considering your conditions, but you just don't have control over what it is that you really want in your life. Now, what I've come to realize over time, as you get older and hopefully I get a little wiser, is that your thoughts have power. Your thoughts have the ability to change things. You know, if you meet someone who has a really positive disposition, chances are there's a lot of really good aspects to their life because that's what they focus on, and that's the bottom line. Whatever you put your energy into, you put your thoughts and you put your physical energy into, it's going to expand in the same way that you give a compliment to somebody, they beam and they feel good. Of course, they're reacting to your compliment, but they don't realize that they're actually making a choice in that reaction. And that's the caveat. That's the little hidden gem within this, is that we make choices based on what we see. We look at something and then we decide it's good or bad. We look at a Mustang or we look at a Camaro and we say, I like it or I don't like it. And that in that right there is a choice. And that's why it's so important to choose wisely, because if you look at something as being a problem, it generally becomes a problem. If you look at it as no big deal, then it's no big deal. So the goal for everyone is to look at everything as if it's green and stay away from those things that are red. It can happen outside of you and it can happen up here. Negative thoughts are red, positive thoughts are green. And it's important to make your life as much green as possible in a sea of red. And if you can manage to do that, as we're trying to do it, everybody is doing their best that they can, but we want to be able to improve. We want to be able to focus on the positive stuff. We want to be able to give love as opposed to negativity. We want to support instead of fighting. So today is all you have, and that's all you can control. What are you going to do today? If it's morning time where you are, then look forward to the day and all the positive things. Focus on all the positive things. If it's evening time, think about you're going to sleep well. I choose to be conscious and fill my life with things that I enjoy, with things that I love doing, with people that I enjoy being around. I choose to love what I do, choose to hang out with you guys and enjoy this entire process. And through that, every day in every way, my life gets better and better. And yours can too. You just got to get in there and you got to do the work. That's it for today, people. Thanks so much for watching. Be sure to subscribe. Hang out with us on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, all those really great places. Be sure to share this video. If there's something that you liked in this video, if it felt inspiring, or if you just liked the cool car show, be sure to share it, because we want to be able to spread that love of automotive coolness across the planet. Okay, peace out, people. Time to go. We'll see you tomorrow.